Hey guys, Cobra here. Eagle and I went to the diecast fair today in Auckland, had a great time, and picked up these items. So we'll start off with these loose items. So the first one I picked up, this loose Toyota 4Runner. Now this is a Matchbox casting. I do have this casting on card, but I don't have an open version. Looks really cool with those white hub wheels. Got some gold tampos and a nice chrome grille, which of course means it's got a chrome interior, left hand drive. There's the base, made in Thailand. So I got this one two for $5, so that was one car and this was the second car. So, of course, I love the old Nissans and Datsuns. This one has a bit of an issue. I think if we tip it on its roof, you can see one of the wheels there is, I think it was this wheel here, I think at the back, was a bit wonky. So metal base, there it is, Hot Wheels, metal base, metal body, plastic bumpers, black interior, and of course as you can guess the doors do open. Just working one-handed, there we go. So you can see that wonky wheel right there. So I thought I'll pick this one up and possibly do a restoration on it. Not 100%. The windscreen's a bit scarred, but we'll see how we go. It's quite nice, I guess, in vintage condition like this, used, got a bit of a story to it. But there's the left-hand drive again. Gold Hot Ones style wheels. So overall, just a nice little casting, and happy to pay $2.50, you know, two for $5 for those. Next we'll move on to this Corgi Fighting Machines F-16 Fighting Falcon, and this one is obviously in decals relating to Operation Desert Storm from the early 90s. So really nice authentic looking decals. I grew up loving the fighter jets, and the F-16 is a beautiful jet. So sorry about the glare there, but yeah, I picked this one up, and this one as well from the same seller. I love the Blues Brothers movies, one of my favorites. I've introduced the Blues Brothers to the boys, and they are starting to like it as well. So I was very happy to pick up this Chicago Police Dodge Monaco. Very famous chase scenes in the Blues Brothers movie with those. So really iconic car from the Blues Brothers movie. And so as I said, I got these two from the same seller, $15, $15. I managed to talk him into a deal, so I got the two for $25, so just knocked $5 off. So I was happy with that. And the last cars that I've got is something pretty special. I don't have this variation of the Nissan Skyline in my collection. So this is actually, there's two wheel variations. One has the PR5 wheels, and which is this one, and the other just has a 5-spoke wheel. I believe this is the harder to find one. So this is on a really good card. I'll show you the back of the card as well. So as I say, this is the first one of these that I have in my collection. But the seller also had an error version of the same car. Would you believe? Well, this is the 5-spoke version actually, if you can see that rear wheel. But look at that error. It's got a wheel error. The front wheel is not chromed. So very cool. I mean, being a Nissan Skyline JDM collector, I love the R32. And so to have an error Skyline GTR R32, that's pretty special in my book. So very happy to have that. So these were $10 each, these Skylines. There's no price on them, but that's what they were, $10 each. So all up, $20, $25, another $25, $50 spent at the diecast fair. But it all goes around. So really happy to have them. Thanks for watching.